Hi guys, Kim here, Papa's Fix the Shop. So I got rid of a lot of stuff that I got behind on and some stuff around the house. And now I'm back on the drumstick, chingadura, the thing that split the ends of drumsticks. So today I'm starting work on this piece of brass that I already squared it all up in the mill, and I dike them to one side because I'm going to begin machining on this guy to make the holder for the blade. And I'm using this 2x1x3 chunk of brass. It's easy to work with, that's fun, but also it's got enough weight to it that it'll help cut push down through the wood. And the razor blade's fixed really nice, and it's in a really good fixture, and it moves, it'll slice, and the weight of this piece of brass will help make it work, hopefully. So that's what the next bit is making this little holder for the blade. Stay tuned, should be cool. It's gonna be all mill work, most likely, on the mill with doing brass. So stand by. I gotta poke a hole in it, and then I gotta take a slitting saw and make a slit in it for the razor to sit in. Then I gotta make a couple of holes to fix the razor in position, and once I get that done, I'll be ready to move on to the next step. Thanks for watching. It's ugly, but it's cutting good. It's a dull blade. I don't want it that dulled out doing other stuff, so it's not too grabby on the brass, but I need to go pretty deep, so it's a wide one. and it's singing like crazy. And it doesn't quite fit this cheesy ass arbor I got, so I'm just gonna pull through, but I gotta go all the way over here, so I'm not gonna film it all. It's gonna be a long process. Also, it looks like that's shaking his camera around here, sitting on the mill, so might have to find a different way to put a camera if I wanna record it. But yeah, this is the next step, getting a slot all the way through that guy. Yahoo. Delrin. One chip. With a piece attached. Look at this. Right there.
Far out of the boat.
Alright. So, it's another part of the drumstick trimmer, splitter, whatever. In any event, I have to make a thing to go on the end to keep the drumstick from going through. You know, it's got to have a backstop, and that's what's coming up. I'm doing this with stuff I had laying around, so I had this 2-inch piece of aluminum. It's actually kind of big, so I'm gonna have to hog off a crap load of aluminum. So should be fun. I faced it. And then I'm going to go in there and I'm going to center drill it, and then I'm going to put the support in there, and then I'm going to bring this outer diameter down. I haven't measured it yet because it's so far off that I don't need to worry about it. It's got to be narrower. Probably it's actually going to be narrow enough that I can turn this down, or I can flip it around and put it in a chuck all the way, because it's just too fat for my chuck. So stay tuned.
Yeah. close.
Working. That's what it's going to look like, huh? Then I should go a little slower. See what it does a little bit slower. Chips, much better. Surface finish is beautiful. There is gonna be a pile of chips in here when this is over with. Yahoo. 1 millimeter total depth of cut. It's a half a millimeter. See, the strings are longer. Kind of rough. I could go faster, but it's the chips. I'm trying to keep the chips under control. Try this with the lights on, with the power on. Alexa, volume 0. Man, there was some pretty sweet music going on. Let's see. Yes, pretty square. Close only counts with hand grenades. See, no. It's a bummer that that you can't get any music on because, you know, I mean, people got valid reasons, I suppose, but seems like if I was a musician, I want people to hear it. All right, here we go. Man, that's pretty damn straight, because I took a half of a millimeter off on one side. Huh. Yeah. I got to figure out how to reset this DRO. If anybody hears this, sees this, and listens to it, I got this DRO and I'm still trying to figure out how to reset it so that it correctly tells me. Well, wait a minute. Yeah, actually it is correct. I must have got it last time. Because I took a half off of the scale here and I'm reading a whole millimeter off of the DRO. So, never mind. Brain fart. Mental flatulence. So now let's face it. Crooked saw cut, and that's the factory side. Well, I mean, they're all saw cut, but that's the one that was on it when I got it. Six more. WD-40.
Thank you.
Well, that's about as far as I can screw it with the tailstock, so from now on it's going to be pecking and poking. It's 6 inches in there and I need to get about 5. So, yeah.
Yahoo!
I'm not going to friggin' put all of that on video. I might do a few shots like time lapse and stuff, but it's just too much chips flying and WD-40 spraying and running back and forth, and you have to pay attention. A big, 15, 30 second drill is my pilot. So, yeah. I've got stuff going on I got to pay attention to other than the camera. Sorry, man. Yahoo. Basically taking it 3 turns on the handle. Size is this? 3/4 inch hole, and it's 5 inches deep. Yeah,
5 inches deep.
Now I got to bore it out. It'll be something for tomorrow. Let's see. Man, I'm telling you, I got boring bar that's the same off size as the hole. That would be kind of nice if I could do it.
Got another one here like this. What's this guy look like?
Oh, that looks like the one. All right. Next part will be another day because it's late and I'm done with this guy for today. Hogging off all this aluminum makes a mess. Let's see. Oof. Yikes, it's too hot to hold on to. I can peek down in there and just see the end down there where it belongs. Once I get farther into it, I might get down in there and tag it a little more. Anyway, step one. Well, this is a step one. Holy cow, it's like 3 or 4, 5. Who knows? I've been out here too long without a Corona beer. Talk at you the next time in the shop. So what we got going on here is now I'm boring out this guy. It is a blind bore. It's 5 inches deep. So the first thing you got to do is be real careful when you start so you don't build up a huge chip load in there and wrap it around the bar. Get it all wrapped around the bar and, yeah, bad things happen. So I'm like going real slow and I'm like dressing. I roughed a little bit and I'm dressing it to keep it concentric. You rough it a while, it gets kind of out of whack, and then you got to go real slow and dress it. Once I get the hole bigger, I can get a little bit more aggressive. .86 RPM. And I'm only taking like 0.4 of a millimeter right now out of the cut. So that's actually 0.8. I did a tiny, tiny cut at really high speed, it'd be better, but I'm not ready to do that yet. So, yep. Cool. Getting a bunch of curlicues back up in the bottom of that bore. It's the worst. Where am I at? Let's see. $27.91. We've got to get to $28.70. .8 of a millimeter. Yikes. Been close. So now I got to get in there and just sneak up on it real slow, like. Just like a little bit of time. I think I might even dress that boring bar tooth I made. See if I can get it a little bigger radius on it. Because this aluminum's kind of gummy. What can I say? It's mystery aluminum in a way. Well, it's got a stamp on it, but it is like not high class aluminum. Trust me.
28.9.
Took about 10 of
them. That's 28.17, huh? Now, 28.18. That was about a quarter of
55.960.
All right. No sense running camera constantly while I'm doing all this. Like a 2/10 depth of cut, 2/10 of a millimeter. Another couple of tenths. Feels all right. Things. Friggin' something's off about this, and they come back the same size every time.
Okay.
Stick out that the angle it can deflect this easily. Twist it a little bit. I don't want to torque this thing down too hard and break something. $28.54. Yikes, that's friggin' real close. Can't get this in here yet. Let's see. Yeah, it is right there. Good thing about having a DRO, I can bring it back. Yeah, so right about there. Now, this
this cut, if it's real close, I'm gonna wait for it to cool off and see how it fit in me. And of course there's some polishing. $167, $165. Could it be that simple? I got a feeling it's real close, boys. It's supposed to go on like this.
Wow.
2000 or two tenths of a millimeter, or yeah, beautiful. Clean it up and I'm done.